The image you are looking at is not a photograph or a painting. It is the human voice made visible. You are looking at the voice of Mrs. Margaret Watts-Hughes, a lady who was born in Dowlais, Merthyr Tydfil in 1847. At a young age, she showed such skill as a vocalist that her local chapel and other local benefactors would raise funds and pay for her musical education. She would eventually go and study music at the Royal College of London. She was absorbed into the history of music, and not only the history, but the science behind it. She was a staunchly religious woman, and she believed that the power of music was something that science and the world is not yet fully realised. So she did her own scientific experimentations around music. She looked at the work the scientists and philosophers before her had produced, and noticed, like them, sound was able to create geometric shapes in different ways. But the one thing no one had fully realised is that the one musical instrument that every human being has, their voice, was not yet experimented on in the same way. What did the vibrations of the human voice create? What would it look like to visualise them? So she set about, in the late 1870s and 1880s, mapping what the human voice looked like. She invented an instrument called an idophone, which she would sing through. The voice would be transferred through the idophone, and upon the other end would be placed a glass or ceramic plate covered in a fine paste paint. There, the vibrations of the human voice would leave their imprint and make the human voice visible. Margaret Watts-Hughes called these creations voice figures. For many people, they were astounded at how the human voice seemed to create shapes that exist in the natural world, flowers, ferns and trees. The collection that you see in now is unique. Margaret mapped out the human voice. She would sing different keys and chords and capture what each one looked like, and then capture what a combination of keys and tones and notes looked like when sung through her instrument, the idophone, and captured onto glass or ceramic. She was also the first woman to display a scientific instrument of her creation and scientific findings at the Royal Society. Aside from her scientific endeavours in the world of music, she also opened several orphanages in London, and over a period of 30 odd years, until her death in 1907, changed the lives of literally hundreds of homeless children on the London streets. This collection and Margaret's story is as individual as you can possibly get. A working class girl from Dowlais, not only becoming a world-renowned vocalist, but also changing the science of sound for all time and still influencing scientists in that area even today.